I swear I didn't plan this, but this week is yet another film that goes by multiple titles. It's Raw Force, aka Kung Fu Cannibals, which is a 1982 Filipino-American martial arts action horror film directed by Edward D. Murphy. You might have noticed I used three different genres to describe this film. That would be because I need you to imagine this. You are of an age old enough to be obsessed with titties and sex, but not quite old enough to understand the mechanics of either quite yet, and you really like coming up with bizarre convoluted film plots with your friends that include all your favourite things like ninjas and zombies and so on. So many naked breasts. Then someone gave you a budget and Cameron Mitchell. Congrats, you just made Raw Force. I will now attempt to describe Raw Force's plot. Strap in, because this is some pretty convoluted bullshit. Totally not Hitler-ier. He's kidnapping girls from Manila cat houses and flying them to Warrior Island, where he's selling the girls to the monks who live on the island in exchange for jade. He's then selling this jade to tourists in Manila, having turned it into statues and trinkets, etc., which he claims is earning him $200,000 per load. Simultaneously, the Burbank Karate Club are on a booze cruise around the Philippines, and one of them wants to visit a cat house, the very same cat house that Totally Not Hitler has chosen to get his next batch of girls from. In the process of acquiring the girls, he discovers that the Burbank Karate Club tour will stop at Warrior Island, which he decides will ruin his lucrative little hustle he has going. So of course, he decides shenanigans should ensue, which leads to a bar fight and a man karate kicking a van. End result, precisely zero Burbank members are put off from their booze cruise. One guy does get a sprained ankle though, pretty obvious who. They promptly rejoin the boat and have the most ridiculous party of all time, which has a barman that looks like this. And then he headbutts a massive block of ice in half. Just before Totally Not Hitler's goons attack the boat and set fire to it, meaning the karate club have to abandon ship, with them ending up on Warrior Island, where, surprise motherfuckers, it's Totally Not Hitler with a bazooka hiding behind that gravestone, because of course it is. Why wouldn't he be hiding there with a bazooka? In what will be a shock result to nobody, the Burbank Karate Club fight his goons off, killing all of them except Totally Not Hitler and his chief goon, who run away into the woods. We then discover that the monks are actually cannibals, who eat the flesh of the girls in a ritual that brings back Kung Fu Ninja monks from the dead, and that they need the Burbank Karate Club to defeat these zombie ninjas before they let them leave the island. Of course, this goes as spectacularly well for the monks as you can imagine. Very badly. Oh, and Totally Not Hitler. Yeah, he gets eaten by piranhas, because that's exactly what this plot needed. A third act piranha attack. The karate club escapes in his plane and takes a whole load of jade with them. We haven't had any explosions yet, so the final shots are the beach and jade mine exploding. Then someone literally winks at the camera, right? That just happened. He did just wink at the camera, right? I haven't finally gone insane, have I? We even get a sequel bit to be continued at the end for good measure. Not to get anyone's hopes up though, because that's never happened. This is very much so bad, it goes right back round to being brilliant. The plot is insane, as I've just described, and more to the point, it is full of unintentionally hilarious scenes and dialogue, such as this little back and forth at the boat party.
My ex-boyfriend couldn't make love to me till I did a striptease first.
What do you call that?
Fetishes. He was into fetishes.
That's really sick.
There is also so much nudity. I don't think you are ever more than 2 minutes away from seeing nipples on or bush. None of it is sexy in any way, shape or form, and is so unnecessarily over the top and seedy. It goes right round to being hilarious. Like in the bar fight, there is just a Filipina dancing on the bar the whole time, who we keep cutting back to, whilst people get karate kicked in the face. Then in the boat fight, Jewel Shepherd's character, who is credited as Drunk Sexpot, is tied stark naked to a bed whilst the fight rages on around her. She told Femme Fatale magazine in an interview she got cast in this film purely because she was willing to get naked, saying, "Once again, I got to show off my boobs and got several close-ups. I could always guarantee myself at least one close-up in films where I went topless. And hey, you do whatever it takes to bring home the bacon." As for the fight choreography, well, that is also bad, except when this guy is on screen, and then it is at least mildly competent. The fight scenes are at least hugely entertaining. The acting is uniformly woeful, but we do get a very shouty performance from Cameron Mitchell, who chews every piece of scenery within a 100-mile radius. And anyone who is familiar with this legend of B-movies will be pleased to know it's one of his "I'm actually leaving my chair" performances, and even shooting guns, and he even does an odd run mixed in between the shouting. Rather than bring the camera crew to my house, I'm sitting in my armchair drunk and never moving ones he often did around this period. Also, it's pretty obvious they had a core cast who they had access to throughout the shoot, and extras who showed up for scenes then weren't available after that, because so many people just appear and disappear when logically they should be in the next scene, then aren't. As for special effects, well, an attempt was made. They are, of course, like everything in this film, hilariously bad. For example, this fire is floating, oh, I'd say a good 5 or 6 feet above the ship that is supposedly on fire, and this sword is clearly bent. Pretty sure you can even see a guy put the blood capsule in his mouth and chomp on it. Just another layer of hilarity, really. So that was raw force. The entire thing is just so ridiculous that it is an insanely entertaining 86 minutes where if you don't ask yourself, "What the fuck am I watching?" at least 10 times, then I have real questions about your sanity. If you liked that, then like, comment and subscribe, because next week I will be back with a lukewarm defense of In Time.